And that's the whole point of the title of the book, Telling a Better Story. So we're... But before we get started, a little bit about this channel. Here we share good thoughts about good words, and on Fridays, I host a live Bible study on Instagram at Race to Walk, and then I publish 2 videos a week. I publish a replay of that Bible study with some study aids, as well as a video about books. So if you're interested in either of those things, be sure to like and subscribe and hit the bell for notifications so you can get updates about new videos. So I actually mentioned this book a couple months ago when I did a video on 10 books on cultural apologetics. And before we start, a little bit about what apologetics is. Apologetics is presenting a reasoned defense for anything. It can be anything. But most frequently, it's used to defend Christianity. And I do have another video on my top 5 books of apologetics in general. But there are a lot of people that are into apologetics now. And most of the time when people think about apologetics, they're thinking about traditional apologetics, which are reasons and evidences for what it is that we believe. But as I mentioned in that video on 10 books on cultural apologetics, just because you have good reasons and arguments doesn't mean somebody's going to come to Jesus. Reasons mean nothing unless we have a desire to really be seeking after God and seeking truth. And as I mentioned in that other video, it's basically marketing 101. You present the benefits, making somebody want what it is that you have, and then you provide reasons for them to make that decision that they already want to do. So what we think of as traditional apologetics is really more like a last stage of evangelism. And when somebody's closest to the door, like knocking down those final barriers to coming into faith. But cultural apologetics is taking a different approach rather than those propositional arguments. And I actually have a degree from Houston Baptist University in cultural apologetics. It's a 2 years graduate program. And its focus is not only learning the foundations of the faith, learning the reasons and arguments for God, but being able to engage with culture and showing how things that are true and good and beautiful, the things that people are drawn to and recognize as good, are really aspects of God, that all truth and all goodness are just a reflection of who God is. It's more about coming alongside somebody and having discussions about thoughts and where they're at and walking with them closer to Christ. So Joshua Chaparral's book is really about that, about having friends that you care about, that you want to see know God, and walking with them as they draw closer to God. He calls this the inside-out approach, that you have to know what somebody's story is before you can have a discussion about them. Sometimes I think you see in traditional apologetic approaches, you know, you have a series of statements, set arguments, and people just think that they can go down the list. So the approach that Joshua Chaparral takes to witnessing to people is really the same approach that Tolkien took with C.S. Lewis. You know, you learn where they're at, you're interested with them as people, and you walk with them and have conversations. His advice is to get people to tell their story. You know, who are they? Why do they believe what it is that they believe? I think he says it in this book that nobody wants to be a project. You know, people have to know that you actually care about them as a person, as an individual, that you recognize them as a unique individual that God's made them to be, and you value them for that, regardless of where they're at in their beliefs. So in Telling a Better Story, it kind of tells us where we're at right now, the state of the church, the state of society, the different sort of worldviews that people have, and with each of those worldviews and those positions that are off-center from the Christian faith, he gives you examples of how to have conversations with people about what it is that they believe. In other sections, he does give apologetic arguments, but he presents it in a way of how you can tell the Christian story. And that's the whole point of the title of the book, Telling a Better Story. So, for example, telling a better story about apologetics, like what the traditional approach is versus what he calls the inside-out approach. And that's In Search of a Better Way, The Story Lives On, What Time Is It, Talking to Humans. Sometimes the way we present things is not the way people talk or understand things. And this inside-out approach. The next section is Offering a Better Story, Imagining a Better Meaning. So what is the meaning and purpose of life? Imagining a Better True Self. Because a lot of times people don't really have their own sense of identity and worth, and they're looking for that meaning, right? And so the God who tells us that we have value because we are created by Him and made in His image. So regardless of our circumstances, regardless of our history, regardless of our actions, regardless of anything else, that we have this value and worth as a person. And then it's imagining a better happiness, imagining a better inclusiveness, and imagining a better reason. And in this part, he discusses some of the barriers that we have to this sense of this belonging and the sense of community that we all want, but we don't seem to be able to get to, and how God's plan of redemption actually provides a solution to that problem. And the last section is objections to the story. And this, he goes over several common objections to Christianity and goes through the apologetic argument, but he frames it from the perspective of having conversations with people, because I think there's a lot of apologetic books out there that may give you those arguments, but how do you actually talk about them with someone? And this book helps answer those questions. It helps get your mind into looking at these conversations as being communal, being in relationship with somebody, and really having a friendly conversation with the other person rather than being adversarial. So this just came out, I think it was the end of last year, but I do have a video on top 5 books to give to new Christians, as well as top 5 books on Christian apologetics. And I do still stand by those books, but if you are wanting to not only know the arguments and you're just kind of wanting something that can help you have better conversations, I think that this book would be a good choice. Actually, we just finished this up in the book club that I'm in, and it really seemed to me like it wasn't really any new information, because the approach that Chatro is talking about is exactly what we learned in the cultural apologetics program at HBU. Other people in the book club that also graduated from the apologetics program said the same thing. One person said that it was just kind of like a little refresher from what we went through in the program. So Chatro is actually the executive director of the Center for Public Christianity and the theologian in residence at Holy Trinity Anglican Church in Raleigh, North Carolina. So he doesn't have any affiliation with Houston Baptist University, but his book is pretty much lockstep with how HBU approaches apologetics. So if you don't want to get a degree in cultural apologetics, but you want to know a little bit more about it and be able to have better conversations with people, just pick up this book and it will give you a good overview. But that is Telling a Better Story by Joshua Chatro. And let me know if you've read this or if you've read other books on apologetics. It really helps you not only understand the arguments, but really have those conversations so you could communicate those arguments. Let me know. But thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.